Hi, and welcome to ISBI. This is part 2 of my wooden lathe build. If you haven't seen part 1 yet, please watch it first. Today, I'm gonna make the belt and motor cover. I have to mention that I had no plan for the cover construction. So I made the cover step by step by using mostly leftover pieces from other projects. Hold it in place, make some markings and cut them as it goes further. I also don't show the cutting of the pieces in this video because they are no fancy cuts. Here I glue and nail the first few pieces together. Some pieces I will attach later are just added by gluing them on. To change the speed of the lathe, I need to access the belt from the top of the headstock and from the motor side. So I want covers to be easy to open. Therefore, I add hinges to every cover part. So far, so good. In order to have covered as most as possible, I add more pieces to the cover box. I screw on the cover box again and test if it fits properly. For the locking mechanism, I had the idea to use another cover part that acts as a locking latch. With this solution, I can cover another area and lock the covers at the same time. You will see what I mean. This is the cover with the latch. And this is the latch hook that will be screwed to the headstock. To attach the latch hook, I drill two countersunk holes for the screws. Here I mark the positions for the screws with the screws itself. Then I realized that the box collides with the hook by closing it, so I will sand away some material. In order to make it easy to open the cover, I drill a hole to attach a little knob to the latch cover. At this moment, I haven't noticed that this is not a good idea. That's the way it is without plans. Here I attach the hinge to the latch cover before I screw it to the cover box. Here I realize that the screw heads collide with each other, so I change to other screws. Then I realized that the latch cover can't swing high enough to close the cover box. So I decide to go with just the hole. Here you can see how it works so far. To To open the cover, I just use a screwdriver to unlock. And it works perfect so far. At this moment, I had a great idea to lock the top cover of the headstock. Then I attach the top cover with hinges to the headstock. And here is my idea to lock the top cover. I drill a hole for a dowel in the edge of the cover box. This dowel will lock the top cover. To lock the top cover with this dowel, it has to reach inside the headstock. Therefore, I drill a hole in the side of the headstock. I made a flap with a hole that I attach to the top cover. The dowel will lock the cover by catching the flap through the hole. So all the covers are locked to each other. The cover box locks the top cover and the latch cover locks the cover box. This is almost like a puzzle box. Here you can see the mechanism a bit better. In another part of this wooden lathe series, I will add a switch that cuts off the power if the covers are opened. I like this cover locking solution a lot. How do you like my mechanism? Let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!